Okay, welcome once again to the second introduction of this Logix Pro simulator. Okay, what I want to do now is to show you, I don't want the video to be long so that uploading will be easy. Okay, so that's why I called the first one short. So now we want to see other features about of this Logix Pro. Okay, now when you want to do do exercises, you need the instructions, like what we have here. Okay, there is no instruction for this one, but I will teach you other things that you can do from here. Now you can see that all these are maintained contacts. You can see they are maintained contacts. Now, what if I want to change this contact to another kind of contact? Instead of left clicking, you right click. Watch, I'm going to right click. You see, it's now a push button. Look, you can see. It's not a push button. Watch the action now. It comes on and go off because there's no latching. See, it's now a push button. You see, it's now a push button. So I can still change it. See, now it's now, you can see it's now an NC, always on. That is a stop push button. See, it's now stop push button. I can still change it to another switch. This is a limit. It's a limit. Okay, a limit. Let's say a limit switch can be position limit switch. It can be temperature switch, it can be anything, okay? Then the switch that is controlled by a physical property, okay? So now this is the NC. This is the NC of it. The first one, the other one we did was NO of it. So these are where you can, so when you are programming with this, you have options of the kind of switches you can use. Let's assume this is toggle switch. You can see it's a maintain. Once I switch it, it stays there. Okay, but if I make it a push button, when I push it, I leave it, it goes up again. So you can see, you can change these switches to all anything you want, depending on what you want to, the kind of program you want to achieve. Okay, so I hope it's making sense. Okay, so then just put your mouse, once it shows hand, then all you need to do, what you right click, once you right click on it, and you'll be able to get change the switch type to the one of your choice. Okay, now if you look at this place, this is the scan. If the processing of your program is not fast enough, you can increase the scan. You can see 50 is the highest. You can see now is in 41, for example. So if I want to download the program now, okay, say it's in the ROM mode. Okay, let me move from ROM mode. When you download the program, I see it's very fast, kind of more than before. Okay, when it is here, if it's somewhere here, you know, it takes some kind of measurable time. So, and processing time too will also be bad. That kind of, so always list up to 37 to 40. Leave it there. Okay, so that is good. So then another thing that is important is this. When you want to do any work, okay, you want to do an exercise. First of all, let's assume, for example, I choose door simulation. This is the door simulation. Now, there are so many things here. How do I know what to do? I will go to help. I will go to student exercises. Okay? So the student exercises. Now, student exercises will load. Okay? It's going to load. So you have to be online. So once you go to help, okay, you have to be online to do that. You get on student exercise, and then it can give you all this one. Don't worry, just click OK. It takes you there. You have to be online to do that. It takes you here. Then you come to student RS Logix program exercise. Okay, you can see a door simulation here. Silo. You can see traffic control. You can see batch mixing, dual compressor, you can see bottle line simulation. Okay, so what you do, you click on door simulation. Okay, and this is the instruction you will follow. Okay, you follow this instruction. Okay, you read through and you follow. This is exercise one. If you finish it, you proceed to exercise two. If you finish it, exercise three. If you finish it, exercise four. Then this is for further discussion. and all that, okay? So this is how it is for all other simulations there. I hope you get it. Hope you get it. For example, let's create a little program there, okay? For example, here they want us to, you know, when you press this open, this door should open. Let's look at what this one said. Sorry for that. Let's look at the instruction, what it said. Okay, click and close that exercise. Okay, let's look at the instruction and see what the instruction says. Okay, now let's look at it. It said, exercise one. In this exercise, the open and close push buttons will be used to control the movement of the door. Movement will not be maintained either the switch is released. So there will not be a latching, okay? And therefore, the stop switch is neither required nor used in this exercise. However, all other available input output are employed. So no stop because you are not latching. You know, when you stop pressing up, it will stop, okay? So let's look at it. I'll just do small thing just to show you. Okay, now this is open indication. This is the open command, okay? If I take it and put here, okay, that is correct. Then this is the motto, open up. If I will click on it, I will put it here. I can still type it too. I can still type it, but I like picking and dropping. So this is what they want, okay? Even for the closing, I can do for the closing, okay? I can add wrong, so I can do for the closing. I will put this contact here. Then for closing, I put this guy here. Then for down, I need to put the output energized. Then for down, this is the address. I'll put it here. I can make comment on them. I can write words on them, like I say, this is up, this is down, okay? So it's normal. We can always do that, okay? So you can edit symbol, okay? You can edit symbol, okay? So these are the things we can do, okay? So now, this up, this down. So let's see how it works, okay? So what we'll do now is that I'm going to download it to the PLC. It's downloaded. Then I run the program. Let's see if what happens when I click open. You see, it's opening. If I stop, it will stop. Okay, if I say close, it's closing. You can see, this is the beauty of it. You always see, oh, don't mind. You see what happened, because there is no limit. So what I'll do now, I'll go and I'll say reset. There is no limit. So here, I'm going to reset simulation. Okay, so if I go back to simulation, I can say open. Okay, then I can say close. Or I can say close. Okay, if I want it to respond slowly, I will reduce it from here. Now watch it to open slow. You can see the PLC is now scanning it slow. You can see it's opening very slow. So if I want to increase it, I'll just increase it like this. You can see the PLC is now scanning it very fast. Okay, so because I did not put this limit, when it gets up here, it will continue moving until the motor will catch fire, because there is no limit. The limits are not activated. This is the upper limit. It's not activated. So watch what will happen now to catch fire. Watch. I'm continuing opening. It will catch fire now. You see. Boah. Because there is no limit. It tells us that there is no limit. This kind of thing, the motor will spoil as usual. Of course, you know that. So I clean up the mess. So that is it. Thank you very much. Remember, it is still me, MMP Harrison. This is Circuit Space Engineering Services. Okonkwo Olubisi Harrison, known as MMP, is in the driving seat. Please start your journey. I'll be producing. I'll do exercises and then you will be progressing with me. So start your journey. Don't wait for me. I'll be producing my own videos. I'll be sending it to you, so you'll be checking your own. Make sure that you achieve all goals as set out in this exercise. Thank you very much and God bless you. Remember, this is still Circuit Space Engineering Services, Training and Project Division. God bless you.